In this lecture, we'll find the time period of oscillation of a cylinder, or it can be a sphere also, but here we are taking a cylinder in a bigger cylinder having radius r. This is r and this is small r. In this, we give it a small rotational motion and let this be the new position of the cylinder, which is there inside the bigger cylinder, and let the angle theta, which is turned by this cylinder, that is a smaller cylinder, let the angle turned be theta of any point about its center. This is the center, and let angle turned be theta. So theta is equal to the angle turned by the smaller cylinder. Now, since the velocity of the center of mass will be equal to v, will be equal to r into d theta upon dt. If we take the rate of change of angle with time, and at any point of time we have taken that it has rotation has taken place by an angle theta. So what is this angle? Let this angle be alpha. What is this arc? This arc would be equal to r minus r into alpha. Also, the velocity, if let the d alpha upon dt, the rate of change of angle with respect to this center, this velocity of center of mass of this cylinder would be, in terms of alpha, would be d alpha upon dt into r minus r. Velocity of center of mass is same whether you calculate it with respect to d theta upon dt or d alpha upon dt, because velocity is of this point. Let us call it O dash. So therefore, r d theta upon dt is equal to d alpha upon dt into r minus r. This is one relationship. Now, here, what is the restoring force? We have given rotation in that direction. See what is the restoring force. This is the weight mg. This is angle alpha. So in this direction, you take this. If I draw it at this place, this is alpha. Sorry, it will be like this. And the cylinder is somewhere there. This is mg. That angle was alpha. This, you draw this tangent on line parallel to this tangent. So this will be mg sine alpha. And this is the point of contact at this point of time. Take the moments along this point, say point A. The angular velocity is d theta upon dt. Since we have taken theta is the angle which is it is rotating, and the angular acceleration will be d square theta upon dt square of this. If you take from this point, that is along the center O, O dash, along this point also, this will be the angular acceleration because it is rolling without slipping. Now, what is the moment of inertia of cylinder about point A? I would be half m r square plus m r square will be 3 upon 2 m r square is the moment of inertia about point, about the point of contact, which is A. Now, apply that equation, the equation of motion, I into d square theta upon dt square, I into angular acceleration will be equal to minus, because it's a restoring force, mg sine alpha into r. This is the torque which is restoring. So this equation we write, and what is the value of I is 3 upon 2 mr square d square theta upon dt square is equal to minus mg r sine alpha. Alpha is a small angle, we can write it as alpha. Now this relationship, we can differentiate this, so we get r t square theta upon dt square is equal to d square alpha upon dt square into r minus r. Replace the value of theta here, the 3 upon 2 m r square, it becomes r minus r upon r d square alpha upon dt square is equal to minus mg r alpha. So this gets cancelled and m gets cancelled. So we get, take 2 upon 3 here and r minus r here. We can write it as d square alpha upon dt square plus 2 upon 3 g r minus r into alpha is equal to 0. This is the equation of motion of simple harmonic motion, and this is omega square. So omega square is equal to 2 upon 3 g upon r minus r. So omega is equal to 2 upon 3 g upon r minus r, and omega is 2 pi upon t is equal to root 2 upon 3 g upon r minus r. So t is equal to twice pi under root 3 r minus r upon twice g. So this is the time period of oscillation of a cylinder, small cylinder inside a bigger cylinder.